What we're trying to do is not only empower women with technology solutions, but also connect them with senior leaders at insurance carriers to help bring to market solutions that are backed by diverse founders.
So I listen to this. I'm scouting digital and tech trends around the world in order to bring it to you. And I've helped numerous companies to set up ecosystems of digital products and services and to increase their reach with attention hacking.
Hey guys, this is Jen from Quesnay. Did I pronounce this correctly?
Close enough,
okay. You guys organized a female founders pitch here at the InsurTech Connect. Why the scope?
So we looked at a pattern of running innovation competitions around the world and not seeing enough women applicants apply over the last 6 years that we've been running these programs. And we also looked at the lack of representation in finance and insurance, broadly speaking, where you have 60% of employees in insurance are women, and yet at the senior level, C-level, only about 11 to 12% executives at that level. So through our program, what we're trying to do is not only empower women with technology solutions, but also connect them with senior leaders at insurance carriers to help bring to market solutions that are backed by diverse founders. We were really fortunate to attract 119 registrants from 20 countries, so that was really positive result. So we do see that there's a lot of potential women led startups that have really great technology for the insurance industry.
And what your program is also quite known for is that you actively involve the sponsors. So how does that happen with your program?
Yeah, what's really nice about the way we structured our multi-month program is that while sponsors provide financial commitment, they are very much involved as judges and mentors and thought leaders and partners with us in this program. So for example, we invite our sponsors to nominate judges from their organizations that have a variety of expertise, and they participate by evaluating the startup that ultimately lead to our top five finalists. In addition, we have created a mentorship phase where we assess the skill sets of the sponsor organizations and leaders and map them to the needs of the five finalists to ensure that the right amount of coaching is provided to the mentees, the finalists. And through that module, we've learned that it's been a learning experience for both the sponsor executive teams as much as the entrepreneurs. And we're seeing really nice advisory and strong relationship form going forward after the program.
Thank you. In Central Europe, we still have sometimes a situation in the insurance industry that we have all male C-suits, which I think is not quite up to date anymore. How do you explain this, and how could we actually change this?
And I think it's a complicated question. I think that.
Sorry.
I think there are probably a variety of reasons. I think what we're trying to do through our program is build the confidence and support and mentorship that will help women either run a startup or build the confidence and the support needed to move ahead in an organization. I was very fortunate to work in technology and have had mentors who helped me really go after opportunities within the company that I otherwise wouldn't have thought I could do. So I think advisors, coaches, mentors are a big part of what will help change this going forward. And an interesting statistic that I read about in the Women Insurance Report is that only 8% of insurance companies have programs to actually support and create leadership programs for women.
Okay.
I think there's opportunity to develop more of that inside the carrier environment. And hopefully our program is providing ideas and tools like a mentorship module.
Thank you very much for your time and thank you very much for your work.
Thanks.
Hey guys, it would help us a lot if you could hit the subscribe button down there and to make us also grow here on YouTube. Thank you very much.